Back, let us continue with the next problem on frames. So last class we were discussing about the frames without sway, the procedure how to solve by Kani's method. So again we have solved one G plus one building frame one way. So I hope you have understood the procedure how to solve such type of problems where multi-story building frames are given. So let me solve one more problem. So here I will be considering two bay G plus one building frame. So last class the frame which I have considered is one bay G plus one. So now I will be considering two bay G plus one building frame. Okay. So here we are not going to consider entire frame for the analysis. So we'll be making use of axis of symmetry and the symmetrical frame and the symmetrical loadings ultimately, and we'll be analyzing so this particular frame. So as usual, first you need to identify whether the particular is non-sway or sway depending upon those conditions. So first, as I said, so check at the beam level, is there any horizontal reaction developed due to the support condition? If it is there, then it is not subjected to sway. If that is not there, then you need to check on those five conditions: unsymmetrical geometry, unsymmetrical loading, different end conditions, then different moment of inertia of columns, and horizontal loading. So here, if you see at the beam level, so this is the beam level. BEH and CFI. Here or here or here, there is no horizontal loading due to the support condition. So if it is not there, then I need to go on checking those conditions. So the unsymmetrical geometry, so yes, it is not there. Okay, then symmetrical loading, no. Okay, unsymmetrical loading is not there. So here the loading is symmetrical, even the geometry is symmetrical, end conditions. So all the end conditions are fixed only. Then moment of inertia of columns. So I. So this is also I they have given, and this is I. Okay. Though the moment of inertia of beam are different, we are not worried about that. Only if column moment of inertia are different, then we need to check whether it is sway or non-sway. So here, moment of inertia of columns is same, so we need not worry, it is non-sway. Okay, loading also it is symmetrical. So here entire thing UDL, here 100 kN, 100 kN at a distance 1 meter, 1 meter symmetrical loading, horizontal loading it is not there. So all those five conditions are satisfying. Ultimately, this is not subjected to sway. It is a non-sway frame. This is non-sway frame. To analyze the non-sway frame, the procedure is same like the previous problem or the beams of your soil. So four steps: step one, fixed end moment; step two, rotation factors; then iteration table; then finally, final moments. Okay, even calculation part, procedure part. So everything is same. So here, let us come to this problem. It is two bay symmetrical frame. So in previous problem it was one way. So exactly at the center of the beam we have cut the members, and left hand portion we have considered for the analysis. The same moments will be there on that side, but here we'll not be cutting exactly the center of the beam. So we'll be making use of this axis of symmetry, that is this column, that is FED column. So if I consider this as the center of axis, the left hand portion and the right hand portion, it is symmetrical. So which means you are considering VE member, CF member, that beam, entire beam. Okay, so in previous problem, so we have exactly at the center we have cut, so we have considered the relative stiffness as half, but here it is not required. So because we are considering the entire beam, BE is entire beam, CF is entire beam, the axis of symmetry exactly on the column we are considering, it's not required to consider the relative stiffness half again. So I will be consider entire thing. Relative stiffness will be K only, but I'll be analyzing only half of the portion, left hand side. Okay. So if I draw the frame for my analysis, it will be something like this. This is A, B, C, and I will consider this as fixed. Okay. This is F and this is E. This is 2I, 2I, I, and I. Relative stiffness, I will be considering entire thing K, K, for this also K, and K. In previous problem, we have considered for beam K by 2. Here also K by 2, because we are cutting at the center of the beam. But here we are considering entire beam as 1. Okay, that is the change here. So rest of the procedure is going to remain same. Step 1, you will be identifying the fixture moments. Fixed end moments. MFAB, MFBA, MFBC, MFCB. I will be considering only this frame, not this. Now I have considered this and I will calculate what will be the moments developed at this. Okay, then the same thing will be reflected on other side like previous problem. Okay, I will concentrate on this. Loading is not there on AB, even on BC span. On B span, yes, UDL is there, and CF span, concentrated load is there. MF BE, MF EB. So even this is not required. If you didn't calculate, that is okay. However, we are consider this joint, only this fixed moment is required. Okay, MFB minus WL square by 12. Similarly, I want MFCF, MFCF, a concentrated load, minus WAB square by L square. Okay, even this is not required. If you substitute the values and simplify only on CF and BE, the loading is there. You will be getting BE as minus 40, MFBE as minus 40 kilonewton meter. MFCF, it is minus 56.25, minus 56.25 kilonewton meter. MF FC and MF EB, those are not required to write your Carney's boxes and even summation of fixture moments here, these values. But still, if you want to calculate, however you have calculated this, when you write the final moments, that time they may require MF EB, MF E to B, it is same with opposite sign, plus 40 kilonewton meter. So MF FC, F to C, W A square B by L square. If you do that, you will be getting 18.75 kilonewton meter. Okay. So once you calculate these moments at F and E from here to here, so final moment is equal to fixed end moment plus 2 times that. So we require the fixed end moment. So for that reason, I have written this. MFEB is plus 40, MFEFC it is 18.75 kilonewton meter. Okay. So once you get these fixed end moments, step 2, you will be finding rotation factor. Rotation factor at the intermediate joint. So let me rub this. I will be concentrating only on half of the portion. Okay. Step 2, rotation factor. So you will be finding the rotation factor at the intermediate joint, that is at joint B and joint C. Joint member relative stiffness, summation of relative stiffness, then rotation factor minus 0.5 times K divided by summation of K, that is rotation factor. Intermediate joints are B and C. With respect to B, the members are 3, BA, BE, BC. BA, BE and BC. With respect to C, CB and CF. CB and CF. Now, relative stiffness. With respect to a joint, the neck support, if it is fixed or continuous, I by L. If it is simple roller or hinged, 3/4 of I by L. With respect to B, A is fixed, I by L. I is only I by L. I by L for BA, it is 4 meters. B to E, so again it is fixed, I by L, it is 2 I by L, it is 6 meters. 2 I by 6, BE span is 6 meters. B to C, 4 meter span, I by L. It is continuous. After B, there is a support here. So C is continuous joint. C to B, continuous because support is there after B, even this side, I by L. C to F, fixed, I is 2I, L is 6 meters for CF. Okay. So add all of them at a joint, you will be getting 1.0i. This is 0.75i. Summation of rotation factor at a joint. Then rotation factor minus 0.5 times distribution factor k divided by summation of k. You will be getting this minus 0.125. This is minus 0.25. This is minus 0.125. So ultimately summation here it will be minus 0.5. Similarly here minus 0.167. This is minus 0.333. Again summation is minus 0.5. Okay. Step 2, finding rotation factor. Okay, at the intermediate joints. So once you get this, then we need to go to calculation of rotation moments at the intermediate joints by iterative table, that is by drawing the Carney's boxes. Okay. Step 3, iteration table or iterative table by drawing Carney's boxes. Okay, I will replicate here again the same thing. This is the Carney's box at intermediate joint C. This is the Carney's boxes at joint B, and these are B members A, B, C, this is F and this is E. Okay, then you need to write the rotation factors. Fixed end moments at a joint, then fixed end moments near the supports. You need to write all the values. So fixed endowment, only BE is there, MFBE, it is minus 40. MFEB, it is plus 40. MFCF, it is minus 56.25. And MFFC, it is 18.75. 18.75. So now again, if you check the last support, they are not simple roller or hinged. There is a continuation. Okay. We don't worry, directly we can start with finding the rotation moments. Then here the friction moments are zero. Then rotation factors. For BA member, it is minus 0.125. For BE member, 0.25 BE. This is 0.25 for BC, minus 0.125 CB, minus 0.167. This is 0.333. Okay, so then summation of fixed endowment at a joint. So at B, this plus this plus this, 0 plus 0 plus minus 40. So ultimately here minus 40, 0 plus minus 56.25. So here it is 56.25 minus 56.25. Okay, summation of fixed endowment at a joint. You will be writing this plus this. However, here nothing is there. Directly you will be writing that. So once you get this, then we need to start with iteration, finding out the rotation factors, sorry, rotation moments. So what is the formula to calculate rotation moment, rotation factor, summation of fixed moment at a joint plus summation of far end rotation moments, correct? Rotation moments here ultimately you'll be finding at joint B and joint C. At joint B, they are M dash BA, M dash BE, M dash BC, BA, BE, BC. Then similarly, you'll be finding at C, M dash CB and M dash CF. C to B, C to F, I have written here. Okay, let us start with this. However, there are two intermediate joints, so the trials will be more than three at least. Okay, till you get the successive values of rotation moment similar, you need to go on doing this procedure. Trial number one, if I say this is trial number one, rotation factor for BA member, B to A, so minus 0.125. Minus 0.125. Fixed moment at a joint, minus 40, that is at B. Plus far end rotation moments. With respect to B, the far ends are A and E and C. So this is initial step from A0, from E0, from C0. 0 plus 0 plus 0. Ultimately it is 0. This is step 1. Okay. So if I calculate M dash BA, you will be getting 5, this value as 5 kilonewton meter. Then M dash B to E, okay, I will write this here. B to E, rotation factor minus 0.25, minus 0.25, summation of fixed moment at a joint. So here it is minus 40. Then again far ends, 1, 2, 3. It is zero rotation moment. So simplify, you will be getting 10. This is 10 kilonewton meter here. B to E, rotation moment, 10. So B to C, minus 0.125, minus 40, fixed moment, far end rotation moment, zero. First try. Sorry, this is 5. Similar to this, you will be getting 5. M dash C to B, now at C joint, Okay. So rotation factor minus 0.167, summation of inverted joint minus 56.25. So this, then far end rotation moments with respect to C, the far ends are B and F. In the same span, you need to consider. With respect to C, far end is B, but you need to consider this value, not here or here. From B means in the same span. So this plus here, nothing is there here. From here, it is zero. So phi is there. So plus phi. If you simplify this, you will be getting 8.56. 8.56 kilonewton meter. So here it is 8.56. Then m dash CF rotation factor minus 0.333, summation of external meter joint minus 56.25 plus far ends here and here. Again, it is 5. If you simplify, you will be getting 17.07. This is 17.07 kilonewton meter. 17.07. Okay, this is trial one. So similarly, you need to go on doing this trials until you get successive rotation moments at a particular joint in a particular member. They are similar. Okay, so I hope you can do this. Only these value will be changing. Okay. So M dash BA again, rotation factor same, fixed meter joint same, far end rotation moments. From here zero, from here zero, from here one value has come now. So I need to take there this 8.56. In first trial it was zero, now it is 8.56. 8.56. Similarly, 8.56. 8.56. With respect to B, so for all the rotation moments. If you calculate, the values will be 3.93. This is 3.93. This is 7.86. Here 3.93. Okay, these are first trials over. This is second trial. Okay, 3.93. 7.86, 3.93. M dash C to B. Now you need to consider this value 3.93 in second trial. It is, you will be getting 8.74, 17.42. 8.74, 17.42. So this is 8.74. 17.42. First trial is over. Okay, same procedure, same step, everything is same. So again, rotation moments from far end, they will be changing. Then one more trial. So even in the examination, it's not required to show this calculation and again and again. Two trials, at least you need to show it, one not two. Okay, so once you show this calculation part, and then directly you can write the next rotation moment, trial three rotation moment. Okay, so if I write them, 3.9 second trial, even fourth trial you will be getting 3.9 only. So here 7.86, 7.81, 7.81. Here 3.93, 3.91, 3.91, 8.74, 8.74, 8.74, it is same. Here 17.43, final 17.43. So these are final rotation moments. Okay, so in third trial you can stop it, or fourth trial you can again check it and you can stop it. Okay, either in third trial or fourth trial. So once you get this rotation moments, then finally, step four, you need to find final moments. Let me write step four. Final moments. So it is given by final moments, fixed end moments plus 2 times near end rotation moment plus far end rotation moment. MAB, MBA, MBE, MCB, MCF, MFC. So here only let me write MEB, E to B. So these all values. MAB, MBA, MBE, MEB, MBC, MCB, MCF, MFC. So you need to calculate all the values by this equation. However, the last sense, they are not simple roller arranged, then that moment is zero. So that is not required. You need to apply the equation. Okay, MAB, fixed end moment, zero plus 2 times. Near end rotation moment, here it is zero. Far end from B, it is 3.9 plus 3.9. You will be getting 3.91. Okay, so here it is 3.9 or 3.9 kilonewton meter. Okay, MBA, fixed moment 0 plus 2 times near end 3.91 or 3.9 plus far end 0. You'll be getting 7.82. Then B2E, fixed moment minus 40 plus 2 times near end 7.81. Far end from here it is 0. You'll be getting 24.38 minus 24.38 kilonewton meter. E to B, it is fixed moment 40 plus 2 times near end rotation moment 0 plus far end, it is 7.81. You will be getting 47.81 kilonewton meter. Then MCB, C to B. Okay, so C to B or B to C. So let me write this. MCB. So it is, first let me calculate BC. MB to C, fixed moment 0 plus 2 times near end 3.91 plus far end from here it is 8.74. MCB, from here to here, fixed moment 0 plus 2 times near end 8.74. Far end it is this 3.91 in the same span. Okay, in the same span, B to C, C, near end, far end, far end, near end. Okay. So BC will be getting 16.56, and CB you will be getting 21.39. Okay, then we are left out with CF. I'll edit it here. MCF. So MF, BCF, 56.25 plus 2 times near end, 17.43, far end 0. 17.43, far end 0. MCF, minus 21.39. Minus 21.39. Similarly, MFC. So fixed moment 18.75 plus 2 times near end 0, far end 17.43. You will be getting 36.18. 36.18. Okay, so these are the final moments with the equation. So once you get these final moments, then you need to find the other half with the same magnitude, opposite direction. Then you need to draw the actual bending moment diagram. So proposition of free bending moment diagram and support moment diagram. Yes, let me complete this. Yeah, so these are the values. Okay, only this half we have calculated. MAB 3.9. First, let me put the brackets. So this is 0, this is 0 directly in road. So MAB 3.9 clockwise. Okay, MBA anti-clockwise 7.42 anti-clockwise. So it is clockwise, it is also plus. Okay, MBE B2E, it is minus anti-clockwise. E2B plus clockwise. E2C BC plus B2C plus clockwise. So this is also clockwise. CB is also clockwise. So then CF minus, C2F is minus, so F to C is plus. Okay, so these are the directions of the moments what we have formed. So this side, the same thing with opposite sign. Okay, so let me write the values also if you want. 3.9, so BA it is 7.82, so this is BE minus 24.38. This is EB 47.81. Okay. Then B to C 16.56. C to B 21.39. Okay. Then C to CF minus 21.39. Same value with opposite sign. Yes, 21.9. Then this FC 36.18. 36.18. Okay, these are the half portion values what we have found. So this side, the magnitude of the moments will be same with opposite sign. So this is clockwise. This side it is anti-clockwise. Clockwise, anti-clockwise. Anti-clockwise and clockwise. So anti-clockwise, anti-clockwise, clockwise, anti-clockwise. The values will be same. 36.18. This is both the values 21.39. This and this. This is 16.56. This is 7.82, 3.9. This BE, it is 24.38. So 47.81, the same value. 24.38. And this is 47.81. Yes, these are the ultimately final moments. Okay, so only thing, the obvious problem, it is with one way, this is two way. In one way, we have cut the beam exactly at the center and rate of stiffness, we have made it as half. But here, it is two way. So exactly at the column, we are cutting the section, passing the section. So K relative stiffness will be considering full. Okay. Once you get this, then draw your actual bending moment diagram. Superposition of free bending moment diagram and support moment diagram. Okay, So this is inside, here outside, plus minus. So then here and here and here, this is 47, this is 39. Join this support moment, negative, negative, plus minus. This adds somewhere here, this adds somewhere here. Yes. These are the values. Okay. Then this is 36. Just you are joining them. These are support moment values, the values. So you can show it there. Okay, then on beam BE. So UDL was there from here to here, from here to here. Here concentrated load at a distance A and B. So here concentrated load at a distance A and B. Correct? So this is WAB by L, this is WAB by L, this is WL square by 8, this is WL square by 8. And these are support moments. Minus, plus, plus, minus, 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 this is plus, plus. Okay, this is minus, plus, plus. Okay, so this is actual bending moment diagram. So most of the times with respect to Carney's method, the problems will be given a symmetrical G plus 1 or G plus 2 building frames. The advantage of Carney's method is we can analyze a building frame, any type of building frame, a multi-story building frames, a symmetrical and width sway building frames also can be analyzed with respect to Carney's method. Okay. Let me stop it here. In next class, we'll discuss if it is sway, then how to take care the calculation part with respect to Carney's method. Okay, thank you.